everyone. My name is Engineer Arjun Singh. Today we are going to see structural engineering labs. In the first video you saw the structural dynamics lab. In this video we are going to see the advanced concrete lab. So let's go through the contents of the lab. First, as we know, concrete is good in compression, but concrete is very bad in tension. So we need to analyze the concrete behavior, as concrete plays a very important role and in the structure. So analyzing the compression testing and also analyzing the flexural strength of the concrete helps us to design buildings in a more effective way. Now we are going through many of the contents of the lab. First we'll see the stress strain curve of concrete. Then we'll go with the correlation between tube strength and cylinder strength. Third, we'll go through the determination of split tensile strength. In fourth part, we'll go through determination of modulus of rupture of concrete. Correlation between compressive strength and cylindrical strength. Relation between compressive module of rupture, non-destructive testing of existing concrete members, behavior of beams under flexure, behavior of beams under shear, behavior of beams under tension. So now the stress strain curves of as you must have been aware of the stress strain curves of the mild steel, we know there is certain fracture point of a element in which the structure breaks. So and there is a limit of elasticity in a structure. If we say elasticity, means that the stress is directly proportional to the strain. This means that the structure will re-establish itself into its own shape after being compressed or after being stretched. So the stress strain curve of the concrete is very important. The correlation between the cubical strength as well as the cylindrical strength. A cube is basically casted in every moment of when the concrete is being casted. A cube is also simultaneously casted and tested. Cubical strength of the concrete represents the compressive strength of the concrete. As you must know, we must be aware of the M25, M30, M40 grade of concretes. What does the M25 means? M means the mix, 25 means the strength of the cubical strength of the concrete after 28 days. So this strength of the concrete depends upon how is the mix and how is the how much is the content of the concrete, like cement, sand, aggregate and water. So we analyze these contents, we basically shuffle the amount of water content on the aggregate to basically test the strength of the concrete. And the cylindrical strength and the cubical strength, there's a difference between the cylindrical as in the cubical strength. We'll see further in the lecture. Now the there are various kinds of tests on the beams. You must have done those who are in the civil side, they must have done these tests in the in their engineering career. These are the flexural strength of the beam, beam under shear, behaviors of beam under shear. We basically cast a sample of a beam and then we apply a certain amount of load onto the center as well as the sides of the beam to see whether the structure can sustain that amount of load. We analyze these figures, we see in the labs if this conventional steps of concrete are beneficial or not. Now as in the today's scenario, we can see that glass reinforced fiber is being poured into the concrete. Basically, as there are small nanoparticles of glass fibers which are being added, say 1 or 2% of the concrete mix. Basically, these fibers act as a secondary reinforcement to the structure, so they impact strength to the concrete. there are many various advancements like various fibers that can be added to the beam. As we know, there is a very good response of concrete under compression. We need to improve on the tensile strength of the concrete. So to increase the tensile strength of the concrete, we have already imparted reinforcement to the concrete. That is the reinforcement, that is the steel bars are good in tension. So they take the tensile load. But there are small cracks in the concrete which develop due to basically fatigue or various kinds of loading like creep after a certain period of time. So these small cracks can be that are developed in the concrete can be compensated and can be reduced with the help of secondary reinforcements that are being incorporated in today's concrete casting methods. So these are types of concrete testing labs. You can also visit these labs at any civil site. Each and every civil site has a basic compression testing machine, tensile testing machine. These are the testing machines that are required in the lab, in the site also, for the analysis of say site reinforced concrete methods. This is the cylindrical section of the concrete which is being tested for compression, and this is the concrete mixing machine which as you can see is used in labs, which can be basically incorporated, and this can be used. Basically this is a manual rotating machine. The person which is shown in the figure is rotating the machine for a good design mix. This is the slump cone test. Basically various kinds of tests are being performed in the labs. This is a tensile testing of flexural testing of beam. As you can see, this is a beam which has been it is a simply supported beam which has been which is being rested on two supports, and a load is applied onto it by a certain compression testing machine or a different kind of machine. So we see the bottom, we can see that after a few particular period of time, there are been cracks developed at the bottom of the beam. So this is enough for today. Thank you for watching.